So welcome back to the channel, everyone. If you're new to the channel, you might as well subscribe. I post music related videos with some spice, so yeah, let's get straight into it. So I started listening to some Eilish in 2017. I had this one song on my playlist and I was rocking with her. I'm like, yeah, this is nice. Then out of nowhere she starts dropping this and I was like, whoa, this is some good music here. Then I started looking at her music videos and she's moving a bit crazy. But I haven't seen all of them, so let's take a closer look at them and see what's going on. From my own experience listening to this Eilish music, I realised that she's actually kind of crazy. So I'm listening to this nice soft voice sounding so sweet. Then I just peep the lyrics and I'm like, whoa, look at this. My Lucifer is lonely. So we all know that she's actually so sad because she's scared of getting her heart broke, the usual story, this and that. But then out of nowhere, 2019, she drops this Demon album. So this album cover alone is a bit mad. Look at this. How is this kid's music? But you know what? This reminds me, whoever her producer is needs some clout tokens because they really be taking her music to the next level. The production is out of this world. Very nice. So let's take a closer look at her first few music videos and we'll see what's going on in her new stuff. Do a little bit of comparison. See if we can figure out a little storyline. So yeah, let's get straight into it.
Also, before we get into the video, I'm not a Billie Eilish expert. Don't take this video too seriously. Everything I say is fiction. And yeah, this video is just for fun and just have a little conversation. So yeah. So to start off, we're looking at Ocean Eyes. So this video starts off with Miss Eilish wearing some makeup and standing in front of a spotlight. But the light is a bit distorted, so she's a bit confused. Next thing you know, some hands start coming through looking like they're trying to grab her. So I think this could either be the fans trying to get a hold of her or some labels trying to get to sign a deal. But if you're feeling crazy, this could be some demons trying to get her. Ooh. But realistically, I think it's probably some record labels because you can see on her fingertips, she's covered in ink. And she's just like, what's going on? Next thing you know, she ruined her makeup and she's looking like a mess. And the hands coming for her and some crazy effects going on. So I think all of this symbolises how crazy her life is starting to get. So yeah, and then this basically leads on to the next video, Bellyache. So this video starts off with her waking up in the desert. So I think she done this because she wants to show that she's lonely. And then she just starts strolling down the road. But then she realises she got a bag. So she just starts blowing this money. Literally blowing this money. Like it's nothing. And then she just finds this flower. It's probably the only natural thing she has. But then she just done dashed that on the floor as well. Still blowing this money. Until the police pull up on her. So this police could symbolise like critics or haters. Because the bloody police, mate. Eating their donuts on duty. Stopping her from moving forward. But then we see the natural part of herself standing behind her. And then we see the wind push it down. So it died of natural causes. This is so sad. But then we have Bored. So this video we see her climbing this ladder. And she's surrounded by speakers. That's surround sound. And she's out here on these long ladders trying to get to the top. I think this could be a metaphor for the music industry. And how she's trying to get to the top. So as she's climbing, she starts to lose balance. And she could just fall off any minute. But this is Billie Eilish we're talking about. So she starts defying the physics. And just starts sitting on the ladders. But the next thing you know, she decides to just chill where she's at. Because maybe there is in the top and it's all just an illusion. She's just listening to the music. So then we have Watch. This video is so crazy. So we start off with the bloody ladder again. But there's some cars surrounding it. Literally putting a spotlight on it. And Miss Eilish pulls up with some chains or some long nails or something. And then these people just run up on her and tie her to the top. Which I think symbolises the fans trying to keep her at the top. Making sure she stays there. And they start dancing around her like they're worshipping her. But the thing is, she looks like she's a witch about to get executed. But I don't know. So yeah. Then we just see Miss Eilish sleeping in a room that looks like the one from Pretty Little Liars when they're trapped. But yeah. And then, next thing you know, she took a page from The Weeknd's book. And she start walking up to herself like, bitch, you a witch. She just lights herself up. So this could mean she's burning the fans' version of herself. And she's making herself up again. So as she's burning, the fans are loving it, because it's fire. So in the next video, I Don't Want to Be You Anymore, we see her talking to herself in the mirror, saying how she doesn't want to be what everyone perceives her to be, or what she perceives herself to be even, which is a bit confusing. But yeah, then it gets a bit tricky, because the camera starts switching sides, and we don't know which one is real, whether the reflection's real, which one's the reflection, and then she starts having some sort of breakdown, and she's just going crazy. So in the next video, we have Lovely. So we see her stuck in a box. She got her chains wrapped around her, classic Billie Eilish. And can't forget the headphones. Obviously we gotta have the music running. And then we see a man like Khalid there as well, rocking his chains, except his ones are a bit more swaggy. And then we see what I think is a representation of her relationships. and we see them have their moments. This is so sweet. Then we see her push him away like, nah, not today, mate. Then out of nowhere, the cloud comes through, starts raining on them. And as it's raining, the box is getting filled up. So as the rain fills up the whole box, they're basically dying. This is sweet until the water turns into ice and they're cuddling, so sweet. And then they just die. The ice has taken them. This is so sad. Moving forward to the next video, we have hostage. Similar situation. We see Eilish chilling in some plain white room and there's some guy chilling on the floor. And I'm guessing they're showing their relationship again because they're having their sweet moments. She's pushing him away again. Then she comes to him, then runs to him. But I think this is basically her showing that she's getting more famous and he can't handle the attention she's getting. So he's basically hostage to her in this relationship. So she's coming up to him and then dashing him away. But then she hits him with that, would you still love me if I was a snail? He said, of course. But she's obviously not going to believe him. So she's mad again. So as they're doing this on and off toxic relationship, they're getting pushed together. They're getting pushed together by these demon hands, which could be the paparazzi saying, who's this guy? Or the fans saying, he's some ugly guy, what's going on? But the ultimate point is, he's getting caught up in her shenanigans, getting wrapped up in the situation. So we see the darkness come in and the demon basically wraps him up. This is also the scary bit, watch this. Speaking of scary bit, now we have when the party's over. So we see a glass of ink chilling on the table and then she just starts drinking that shit. So I think that's a metaphor for like the contracts she's signing and how it's killing her. So I feel like they said to her, yeah, this is the glass of coke, have a quick sip. She's like, I'm so thirsty, let me have this. Next thing you know is ink, but it's too late. But she starts crying. But she's only crying ink, as if she's only a name on a paper and she can't have real tears. Or that the industry rely on her tears to produce that melancholy music. Or maybe the fans just prefer her sad music to her happy music, I don't know. But ultimately the main point is, she's not happy and it's all a mess. Now, we have Bury a Friend. So this starts off with this Donnie in bed, who could be a human sacrifice to the devil. By the way, don't take this too seriously, I'm just trying to make a video. Everything I'm saying is just waffle, it's just jokes. So yeah. So then, you know when they say there's a demon under your bed? Under this guy's bed, we see the demon Eilish. And then she's just watching him. Next thing you know, she's walking through this haunted house. Lights flickering and shit. And she starts applying for the role of the exorcist. Start doing all this demon shit. And then she just gets grabbed up by demons or something. I don't know. Or some industry donnies. And they just start probing her, injecting her with all this demon juice. You see what happens in the later video. And then she just starts walking like this. And in my religion, they say some scary stuff about this walk. So be careful out there. So as she's walking, she's probably thinking she's in control. But then she just gets possessed, start floating. But in the video Bad Guys, she's basically having so much fun with her bubbly self, comes out of a wall and stuff, doing some funky dances. But then she just start acting all possessed and shit. It's a bit weird. So yeah. But now, to the most scariest one, we have this. I'm not even going to say nothing. My Lucifer is lonely. But yeah, now we have the scariest one. This is a basically visual representation of the story of the devil. So long story short, the devil was an angel. And then he gets sent to hell for being a demon. So yeah. So we see Eilish get dashed from heaven. And she's looking like Venom from Spider-Man. But the next thing you know, she starts looking like a demon. And she starts talking some crazy stuff. So this could be symbolism of how the industry made her sell her soul. So she could spread her wings. Literally. So they basically created a monster. She's not really a monster. She's just a woman making some good music. So long story short, she's telling her kid audience she's not for kids anymore. And she joined the dark side. Now we have Xanny. Again, she's telling her audience she ain't doing up no kid music no more. She's popping them Xans, looking like she faded. She's singing her favourite song, looking all sad. But then we just see some guy start ashing some cigarettes on her face. And then everyone else just starts putting cigarettes on her face. So crazy. So I think she's basically trying to say how everyone's using her and abusing her for the views. So sad, but she basically says that nice, plain and simple. But yeah, next thing you know, we have Everything I Wanted. Again, showing the classic relationship story. We see her cruising through the city with her mans. They're looking like they just had a fight. So sad, doing up silent treatment. Then she just starts driving into the ocean. And they start sinking. I think this car symbolizes their relationship and how they're on the road. Going nowhere. And the only way to stop it is the classic Romeo and Juliet style. They basically drown. So Eilish is the driver, clearly. She's testing their relationship. Seeing how deep they can get before it's too late. So she's just putting her foot down in the ocean and they both look up at the light in their last moment, that's the only way to escape this relationship. But they just want to test how much they love each other. So this is so sweet, they're holding hands, their last moments, so sad. But yeah, the last video we have, Therefore I Am, we basically just see man like Eilish rolling through the empty shopping center, and she's just having so much fun. That's about it. So yeah. So that's the end of the video. And in my personal opinion, I don't think that she sold her soul, but I think she does play with the idea of selling her soul to like a label or something more realistic. Either way, let me know what you think down below in the comments, and let me know your favorite music video she put out. And yeah, be sure to like and subscribe to see more conspiracy videos. Maybe check out my weekend one, because that's a banger. So yeah, see you in the next video, mate.